That's a lot of fun. Hey guys, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I'm here to find out, are cheap pedals any good? And that sounded mint in the intro. You know, like that's, I love a good delay. Channeling my inner Adam Jones there, it's awesome. Let's get into it. Now the way the world is now, you can get so many awesome things for not a lot of money. Back when I first started playing guitar, cheap pedals did suck. It's just kind of what it was. To get like a holy grail pedal, you had to spend hundreds of pounds to get the pedals of our idols used and so on and so forth. But these days, here in 2023, you haven't got to spend a lot of money to sound absolutely mint. It's bloody fantastic. With that, there's lots of awesome cheap pedals out there. There's tons of them. I can't include them all on this list. So there are a few that I've obviously missed, some very obvious ones as well. So comment down below your favorite cheap pedal and why people should check it out, why people should buy it. And if you want to check out any of these and buy them for yourself, everything is linked in the description box down below. There's more than this as well. Everything is linked in the description box down below so you can check it out at pmtonline.co.uk. One thing off the bat that I really can't stress enough is that I know I'm using the word cheap for these pedals, but in some cases they're in no means cheap. £75, under £100. Some of them are £30, £40, but some of them are up towards the higher end, towards £100. I should really say more affordable, but a lot of people these days think that you have to spend multiple hundreds of pounds to get a great sounding pedal. It's just the world we live in right now with all the Strymons and the Friedmans and the beautiful boutique pedals out there, the Keeleys and the JHSs, which are fantastic, but to get a great sound, you still haven't got to spend a lot of money. So I am using the word cheap, but in some cases, these aren't cheap, they're just more affordable. You can get a great sound at a more affordable price instead of spending absolutely, or instead of thinking you have to spend absolutely hundreds, if that makes sense. I probably should mention about the gear I'm using. I'm using my Kramer Pacer into the pedals, which are powered by a MXR ISO brick, going into a Blackstar HT Stage 100 Watt Mark II head. I'm hearing through the cab, but you guys are hearing through the Two Notes Torpedo Captor X, which has a Blackstar cab impulse response, going into a zoom thing and then into your ears. I like using this amp because the Blackstar HT stuff sounds the same. Like you've got a HT5 or a HT20, a little small Blackstar amp. Sounds the same as the big one. This one's just bigger and louder. We've got offering smaller, big, beautiful brands that you'd expect, like Boss, Electro Harmonix, Fender, Blackstar, and Big Top. I picked out some of my personal favorites to talk about in this video, but obviously within each brand, they do so many awesome pedals, a huge array of everything that, everything, delays, reverbs, modulation pedals, overdrives, distortions, tuners, and everything in between. These are just some of my personal favorites. Let's start with one of the most recent of the bunch, the Fender Hammer Tone pedals, and my favorites from the bunch of those guys are the Space Delay and the Reverb. Let's hear them. Fender's Hammer Tone pedals, which came out, like I said, in last year. And there's a few different variants in the lineup. There's metal pedals, overdrives, choruses, modulation effects. These are two of my favorites. They are up towards the higher end of the price point. Like the metal ones, like 50 quid and stuff like that. These are more like £70. But they're bloody fantastic and they deliver some great classic tones. You've got a reverb pedal with three different kinds of reverb built in, hall, plate, and spring. And you've got a space delay, which is an old kind of tape echo. And to get a great space echo tone, you usually think you have to spend hundreds of pounds on a big fancy T-Rex replicator or something, but not with the Hammer Tones, they're bloody fantastic. This is the dry signal. There is a full video on these pedals at PMTVUK, I will say, I'll link that in the description box down below, as there is on multiples of these pedals in this video, but space delay. Really easy to use, super awesomely laid out as well. So you've got time, how quick do you want the delay, you've got the feedback, how many delay repeats you want, and the overall volume. Modulation to add a little bit of warble to the repeats, like an old tape delay has kind of warble on the repeats. And the feedback, which controls which different tape head, because there's a couple of different tape heads in old school tape echoes, which one it's picking up, so it gives you a different kind of rhythm pattern. Listen. So all the Hammer Tone pedals are set out super easy to use as well, and the reverb is no exception. Time for how much reverb you want, damper, taking off some of the high end, like dampening the tone a bit. Level, two different type of tone controls. You want a bright or dark reverb sound, and a three-way type switch, which gives you the spring, plate, and room. Great sounding reverb, isn't it? It's bloody fantastic. I think I said spring. There's whole room and plate in the Hammertone Fender Reverb, not spring. But yeah, check out all the Hammertone pedals because they're awesome. Let's hear that with some distortion now. Yeah, Fender Hammertone pedals are awesome. Check them out in the description box down below. This beautiful little thing is an Electro Harmonix, is an Electro Harmonix Big Muff. Now, the intro, I had the regular Big Muff, the Nano Big Muff, but I am in an active music store right now, and someone just came in and said, can I please purchase that, because it's amazing. So that one's gone. This one is awfully similar, but with some lovely little fancy nuances on. Nuances built into it. It is still under £100. It's not as cheap as the original Big Muff, but the tone's still pretty much there, but with some added features. Let's get into the Big Muff and why it's bloody awesome and not a lot of money, and why it's... Every studio in the world, big or small, probably one of your favorite records as well, will at some point on it have an Electro Harmonix Big Muff. That's quite a claim to fame. So the Big Muff is obviously a fuzz, right? But it's not coined as one. It's coined as a distortion slash sustainer. It does both of those very well. It certainly adds a lot of sustain. So the Big Muff came around in the 70s and has been used by so many iconic artists over the years. Again, please comment down below your favorite Big Muff user, from the Smashing Pumpkins all the way through to Jack White. Jack White is my favorite Big Muff user. That's why I personally have a Big Muff, because of Jack White, the whole... Bloody minute, and it's so easy to use as well. So, volume control, how loud do you want the fuzz to be? Tone, do you want a bright or a dark fuzz? Or a bright fuzz? Distortion, I should say, sorry. And sustain on the end, how much sustain do you want? How much fuzz do you want? With a tone wicker, you get extra fancy goodness. So the wicker switch, it alters the high end, so the high frequencies. Hopefully that comes across okay on YouTube. You kind of have to feel it as well. It's a lot of fun. And the tone switch takes away the tone control. So when you add a tone control, whether it be to a guitar, an amplifier, or a pedal, like in the signal chain, it actually takes away some of the tone, because it has to go through the circuit of the tone control. And this takes it out, so notice the change. Is that Pete and Alex, or we're good? So notice now this does nothing. We'll be right back. I love the Big Muff so much. It's not a lot of money, and every guitar player out there should at one time in their life own a Big Muff. Simply fantastic. There are obviously so many other pedals that Electro Harmonix make that don't cost a lot of money. Their entire range is great, again, from delays, modulation effects, overdrives, distortions, all just as famous as the last in some cases, like the Clone series. That is the iconic Come As You Are Nirvana riff. I was going to use one of them, but that sold earlier today as well. So yeah, there's so many awesome pedals that don't cost a lot of money in Electro Harmonix's lineup. Check them out in the description box down below. But yeah, get yourself a Big Muff. Wonderful little creatures are big top pedals. Now, I spoke about big top quite a lot recently, but that's because they're new and they're bloody mint. They don't cost a lot of money. These are three of my favorites. They do, again, loads in this range, and they are all like sub £50, in some cases £20-30. Again, all linked in the description box down below. I'm not gonna mention any actual prices in this video. You gotta click the link to find them. Anyways, big top, I've got the Fuzz, which is the Creepy Clown Fuzz, the Candy Floss Chorus, and the Juggler Reverb. Three lovely pedals. In the intro there, you heard the chorus and the reverb for that lovely little rendition of, what's it called again? Pure Imagination. The reason I like these pedals so much is not because they sound great and they don't cost a lot of money, it is because of the fact that no matter how big or small your pedal board is, there's always room for a big top pedal on there. Because they're tiny, the small footprint is absolutely awesome, they don't draw a lot of current from any power supply, and there are some quite funky ones as well. There's a looper, which is awfully handy, there's a tuner, and this one at the end, the Juggler Reverb, has different kinds of reverb effects put into it. It's not just like a standard reverb pedal or like the hammer tone where there was three different kinds. There's lots of different kinds in this. And for a pedal of this footprint, it's absolutely crazy to have that kind of technology in a little box like this. Let's start with the reverb then. So this is a clean sound, straight into the black star. Juggler Reverb, first one is the hall. Fantastic. So the big knob in the middle controls which kind of effect you want. The top left is decay, how quick you want the reverb to fade away, and the mix is how much of it you want in the signal. So there's hall, room, plate, echo, tile, flanger, ducking, chorus, and lo-fi. Let's go to the flanger one, because I like a bit of flange. That's ducking. There is a whole demo on these pedals of PMTVUK. Lo-fi seems pretty good. Metallic kind of. Ducking I had on before. Ducking's pretty cool. Pretty cool. Let's move on to the chorus now. The Candy Floss Chorus, a straight up chorus pedal. Does what it says on the tin, makes this sound like this. Mm-hmm. How much chorus do you want? How loud do you want the chorus to be? And how deep and vibrant do you want that chorus to sound? I like maxing everything on a chorus because I like to go little pedal. Now another reason these are great is because if you're not much of a chorus user, but you need a chorus for something, like if you're in a band and you need to play something like, you need chorus for that, but you don't want to buy a big fancy chorus, this is a great little pedal just to sneak on the corner of your board, because like I said, there's a space on anyone's pedal board for a big top pedal. Sneak on the corner of your board and you're good to go with your little secret weapon chorus pedal that hasn't cost you a lot of money but will deliver on the tone. My favourite of the bunch, I think, is the fuzz pedal, because it's absolutely rad. The crazy creepy clown, yeah, creepy clown fuzz. Right level of kind of choky, cutting out fuzz. With a volume, a tone, and a fuzz control. Ridiculous fuzz. For lots more info on big top effects, in the link in the description box down below, get yourself to PMTOnline.co.uk and check them out. Next up, we have some of my favourite offerings from the fine folk at Boss. Got the SD1 Overdrive and the BD2 Overdrive as well. Again, there are so many iconic pedals in Boss's lineup that don't cost a lot of money, like the DS1. Like, I was going to include the DS1, but I thought I'd show you these two because they are both overdrives, but they are quite different at the same time. Blue Driver and the SD1, this is my own personal SD1. I've had this for years and I love it and use it in lots of PMTVUK videos. Never owned a Blues Driver, but after this video, I just might. So the little crack with Bosses, great little pedals. The OD ones and that came out in the late 70s. That's what this is based off. The Blues Driver is a bit more of a, has a different kind of stiffer kind of tonal characteristic. They're both as beautiful as the last. This isn't just for blues. So like if a regular Black Star. And this song. That could be a metal pedal right there. The reason everyone loves Boss is the fact that they don't cost a lot of money and they're super, super easy to use and they're built like absolute tanks. They're going to outlive all of us. And the fact that a lot of our favourite guitar players use them. So many people use the SC1, the DS1, especially the little orange box distortion. The Blues Driver. So many famous people use these pedals and they don't cost a lot of money. So you can get that same kind of, you can get the same tone and not have to bust the bank while doing it. These are my favourites, I thought I'd use them in this little video right here. They're both laid out the same, both have drive controls, tone controls, and level controls for how much gain that you want. That's the Blues Driver and everything at noon. Overdriving, or pushing to the next tonal plateau, an already slightly distorted amplifier. There's a few different ways in which you can use both of these pedals. You can either use them as an always-on pedal, so that's like your core tone. Using a boost for solos, you've got a bit more saturation, a bit more gain when you go for those big solos. Or you can use them to add a bit of grit to a clean amp. And this will really show you the difference between the BD2 and the SD1. So this is a clean channel. If your amp is just a clean amp, you want to add a little bit of something, something. An overdrive pedal is a great way to add a little bit of grit without totally altering the tone, like say with a distortion pedal. Because what an overdrive does is it adds something to it. It adds some special seasoning, whether it be the SD1, the BD2 or anything. Adds a bit of seasoning, whereas a distortion takes a signal and totally alters it and adds distortion to it. And that's the difference between overdrive and distortion. So, SD1. BD2. Much kind of stiffer sound. It hasn't got as much, it's a bit more scooped sounding. It is a bit louder, I will say that. That's why I love the SD1 and the BD2, two different kind of, like ones like salt and pepper. You kind of need them both. I need to buy myself a BD2 after this video. Let us know what you think down below in the comments. But again, so many awesome Boss pedals out there for your liking that don't cost a lot of money, which will deliver iconic sounds that we've heard on so many legendary albums over the years. Ladies and gentlemen, have been around for a little while and they're still as awesome as the first time I ever plugged one in years ago. These are the Blackstar LT pedals with the LT distortion and the LT drive. Super affordable ways to go from this to these stupid little pedals because they're really easy to use and yeah, they don't cost a lot of money. And again, like the Boss pedals, they're built like absolute tanks. They're going to outlive us all. So the overdrive does what it says on the tin, so it adds a bit of overdrive, like I said with the Boss pedals, just a little bit of seasoning on top. A little bit of seasoning, that's a healthy amount right there. But your core tone is still maintained there, whereas the distortion totally alters your tone. Notice the overdrive as well features Blackstar's patented ISF control. So along with the gain level and tone, you'll find on both of them, again, tone to make it dark or bright, gain for how much distortion you want, and volume for how loud you want it to be. The ISF shifts where the mid sits to make your tone sound more American, like Mesa Boogie, that kind of thing, or British, like Marshall and that. Drive on the clean channel. Again, there's a lot of drive in this. If you use it a traditional, use it in the way which a traditional drive is used, by boosting an already overdriven channel like this. And distortion just for fun. Back on the clean. And those are the Blackstar LT pedals in all of their glory. Right, a couple of honourable mentions to end with two of my favourite pedals of all time, and the reason I love them so much is because they're not daft, fancy boutique pedals which cost £800. They're pedals that are tried and tested. They are a bit more expensive than the ones I spoke about in this video, but they're bloody legendary. Like I said, my two favourite pedals of all time. I have an S Tube Screamer, this in this case my own TS9, and an MXR Phase 90. They're bloody brilliant. Is what it says on the tin. It's a phaser. This little orange box has graced the board of so many iconic guitar players over the past however many years. This is the block logo one. There is a strip logo, which is a bit more subtle, let's say. There's a whole video here at PMTVUK explaining the differences between the different phase 90s out there. But I like the block logo. Because when it's just past 9 o'clock, it sounds like this. Too early to play that, but you know what I mean. Not just Van Halen, though, this pedal does so much, and like I say, it's been on so many iconic records over the years. So that's the Phase 90. And the TS9 There is the TS9 and the TS808 out there, but I prefer the TS9. You can get a Tubes Human Mini, which is just an awesome little recreation of the TS808, but the TS9 is my favorite because it has a bit more edge. It's a bit more torn around the edges than a TS808. That's it into the clean channel. Same as the boss pedals I was showing you. You can either use this as your, to dirty up a clean channel, use it as your core tone. So a lot of the times back in the day, amps didn't have a lot of gain in. In order to push your amp into that next level of gain, you either had to get it modified or just get something like a Tubes Human. Sustain, it gives you that confidence to really going for the harmonix or going for the longer note. The way I play anyways, it certainly does. It's fun to use with the drive down and the level up as well, because that takes the tone you've already got and kind of judges it out a little bit. Ladies and gents, are some of my favourite cheap pedals that don't suck. You haven't got to spend a lot of money to get iconic tones from the pedals that I've shown you, and all the subsequent pedals that come with each brand, like Boss, Blackstar, Big Top, what else? Fender with the hammer tone pedals, and of course Electro Harmonix with all of their wonderful little gadgets and gizmos. Let me know your favourites down below in the comments, and if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK here on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. Everything I spoke about is linked in the description box down below. Get yourself to a PMT store, try one out for yourselves. We are playing music today on all social media platforms. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.